So in this video, we are going to have an example on business income. So a question goes like, Oloka, an affluent businessman, operates a wholesale shop in Chikubo, one of Kampala's major business hubs. His income statement for the period ended 30th June 2019 is presented below. So this is his income statement. Yeah, up to here. Then this is the additional information required. They want us to determine Oloka's chargeable income for the period ended 30th June 2019 and then determine Oloka's tax liability. Yeah, it's what we are going to handle. So they want us to determine Oloka's chargeable income and then Oloka's tax liability for the year ended. So if you're doing a number on business income, the first thing you are supposed to identify is the net profit before tax. Yes, so here the net profit before tax is 93,200,000. So it's the first thing we write. Net profit before tax, 93,200,000. Then after that, we go to the income statement. The income statement here, this, we leave it the way it is, the sales, cost of sales, gross profit. Then we start from here. Interest on receivables. Interest on receivables, it is taxed and here it was added, so it was treated right. Then VAT tax refund. Tax refunds are also taxed. Yeah, and here they were added. So we leave them the way they are. Then we get the gross income. We come here. Administrative expenses are not taxed and they were subtracted. Because here they said less. All these are subtracted. So they were subtracted. Depreciation. Depreciation is non-allowable. Depreciation is non-allowable. So it is supposed to be subtracted. So it is supposed to be subtracted, but I mean supposed to be added, but here it was subtracted. So we go to our work and then we add it back. So every time you're doing a number on business income, after identifying the profit before tax, the next thing you're supposed to do is to look for depreciation and then add it back. Yeah, because most of the times it's put under expenses, so you look for depreciation and then add it back. It's non-allowable. Yeah, so you come here under non-allowables, profit before tax, then you add non-allowables. So where there is non-allowables, we put depreciation and it was 15 million. Yeah, it's what we put. Then we continue with the question. Marketing expenses, they are not taxed and here they were subtracted, so it was, treated right. Then even rent expenses, they are not taxed, so they were treated right. Then late VAT payment penalty. Penalties are taxed. Yeah, they are taxed, so it is an unallowable and here it was subtracted. We are supposed to add it, so we add it back. So late VAT penalty, it is 800,000. We put it under non-allowables. Then we have salaries and wages. Salaries and wages, they have additional information. Here they told us, even rent expenses has an additional information. They told us rent expenses includes 14 million being paid, being rent paid in advance. So if rent paid in advance, it was subtracted. Yet it's not supposed to. So we are supposed to add it back. Advance payments are not supposed to be included because they are only allowed in the year in which they were incurred. But here, in rent expenses, they included rent paid in advance. So in case a payment in advance is included under the expenses, we add it back. Yes, so We come here, we say rent paid in advance, it is 14 million. Yeah, but in case it was not included, we were supposed to ignore it. Yeah. Rent paid in advance, it is 14 million. Then salaries and wages exclude 13 million, which had accrued as an outstanding amount for some employees. Yeah, accrued expenses are allowed. Yeah, they are allowed. So, but they were excluded. So we shall add them back. Sorry, they are allowed, but they were not included. They were excluded. So we shall come under allowables and we put accrued expenses. So allowable, we put accrued expenses. And then, sorry, my neighborhood has goats, like so many of them, so there is nothing I can do about it. Then the tax agreeable depreciation. The tax agreeable depreciation, it is 12 million, that amount. Eh? Tax agreeable depreciation is the same as wear and tear. It is the same as wear and tear, so it is this amount. And wear and tear is allowable. So you come here under allowable and put agreeable depreciation, which is this amount. Then we continue with our question. We are done with this. Income tax withheld on supplies. Income tax withheld on supply, it is withholding tax. And withholding tax is supposed to be a tax credit. But here it was included under expenses. They subtracted it, yet they were not supposed to. So we have to first add it back. So we come here and say income tax withheld on supplies, it is 5 million. And then here we have provisional tax paid, it is 10 million. It is 10 million, so it was also subtracted, yet it was not supposed to. Yes, so we come here and first add it back, provisional tax, 10 million. After that, we get the profit before tax. We add the non-allowables. We get this. After that, we less the allowables, agreeable depreciation and accrued expenses. This is what we get. Then we get the tax liability, which is 30% of this. And we get this. Yeah. Then after getting the tax liability, we are supposed to less the income tax withheld on supplies and then the provisional tax. It's what I was telling you about tax credit in the previous video. These two tax credits, provisional tax and then withholding tax. They are supposed to be subtracted after getting the tax liability, you're supposed to subtract them. Yeah, so we come here and we less income tax withheld on supplies, which is 5M. Then we also less the provisional tax. And what we get is the tax payable by Oloka. Yeah, so we've answered our question. They asked for Oloka's chargeable income. Oloka's chargeable income is this. It is 98,830,000. Then the tax liability. This is the tax liability. 29,649. The tax payable is this. 14,649,000. Yeah, but they're mainly interested in the final answer, the tax payable this. So this is the tax liability and then this is the chargeable income. So our number is done. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share with your friends. So if you're doing this question, the thing that you must note is the allowables and then the non-allowables. We looked at the allowables, most of the allowables, and the non-allowables in the previous video, these ones. You must note them. Yeah, if you note them, doing this number will be easy for you. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share with your friends. Yeah, let's catch up in my next video. You can drop some questions in the comment section. In case I have the answers, I'll reply.